that deserves a lot of discussion at the end. I would like to introduce Dr. Ferhat Cenkiz. He is a member of our association and a member of AIHF Center Fertility Rabat Morocco. Ferhat Cenkiz, after graduating from Istanbul University, he has completed his master's degree in histology and embryology at Tarakya University. He is the head of IVF Laboratory of Göztepe Medical Park Hospital, a research center in Istanbul, and formerly was the head of the Department of Embryology in different IVF centers. During this time, he showed very interested in sperm morphology, having an ample and multidisciplinary view of round spermatid injection research. Very interesting, Dr. Ferhat, United Nasil Sinis. Welcome to our meeting. Your topic will be temperature monitor and IVF laboratory quality. So the stage is for you. Please, we are waiting for you.
So sorry. First of all, for thank you a lot of for your organization committee, my friend Nurettin and Mustafa Zekeriya. And my name is Ferhat Cengiz. I'm from Turkey. I work for Memorial Dijla Hospital. I am a senior embryologist. I want to talk this today about temperature control and IVF quality control in laboratory. I will try summarize for you because we have a little time, and I will talk about control, medical laboratory standard and quality control equipment and standard laboratory facilities and human rescue and personnel. And last one is take home message for about quality control. What is the quality control? What's the control? In the last year, in the last 40 years in IVF, IVF has changed infertility treatment and at the same time become more complex and adoption, highly technological laboratory procedure, and including freezing oocyte embryos. And therefore, it's very important laboratories apply the maintain and highest quality standards. Quality can be difficult concept understand the often as beholder. In IVF laboratory, often defined by success rate of the clinical result inceptions, determine of stability of IVF laboratory change. For the application of a system in which all personnel know what, how, in he or she, and how often they do it. Quality that is part of high quality laboratory often occurred. Now I talk about factor affecting success ART laboratory. We have a lot of factor affecting success of ART: diagnosis and therapeutic guidance, ovarian stimulation, ovarian oocyte retrieval, OPO, IVF procedure, embryo transfer, luteal phase support, treatment. Condition in success in the IVF laboratory: the basic condition success IVF centers from equation of gametes of embryo transfer, medical equipment, sterile space, and very careful and periodic models of quality control F standardization. Why we need quality control? Rakowski and their friends presentation in World IVF Reproductive Congress. They said laboratory improvements directly affect the result of ART programs, and program results are mostly influenced by laboratory variations. So why quality management? Because we need stability, high performance in all process and minimizing possible errors and to ensure continuous development. Now I talk about quality guidelines and if we want we count them as ACRM, ASHRAE, Colleague of American Pathology, Association of Clinical Embryologists. You now see some publication about quality control in IVF laboratory. And the last one, quality and risk management in the IVF laboratory 2015. By writing Sharon and David Mortimer. It is best book about quality management for the IVF laboratories. Calibration 5 for quality management system, ISO 9001, for medical laboratory standards, and for all ART laboratories, we need 15,189. Our third topic, human resources and personnel. It's a very important point for me. If staff management, we have some main titles, which are experience, must be enough. Writing notification and duties, responsibility and each staff. Now I want to talk about interesting point, which is controversial between employers and employees during years. Although there is research about this issue for the German Society of Human Reproductive Biology and ACRM, it determined as the number of staff has to be adjusted according to number and nature of procedure performing in the laboratory. You see for how many cycle for the year, how many we need a person in work in the laboratory. This is for German society and this is for ACRM state. Training the planning of IVF laboratory staff, responsible and senior embryologists should be undergo continuous training program. And the authority and performance responsibilities and actions may be granted and person after they have defined training have demonstrate that they are educated. Measured of performance of the team members, how to be performance measured. In the short time, oocyte maturation, embryo quality assessment, and evaluation of sperm parameter. In the long time, per transfer and how many pregnancy, and for fertilization and generation rate after ICSI application. Now you see graphics show different IVF personnel in laboratory pregnancy rate after transfer. You see 5/5 personnel is a very low performance showed us. training of new employees is how many our new colleagues, theoretical learning and techniques and application under control, examination result of application period without control, then starting application and permission and teach the new embryologist. Our next topic about standardization of laboratory facility and procedure. Quality control in evaluation result, fertilization rate, by checking embryo quality, pregnancy rate, multiple pregnancy rate, and implantation rate. Let's write about ESHRE. We have many factors affecting pregnancy outcome in IVF laboratory. We summarize some used disposable material, aspiration needle, pipettes, glass material, heat blocks, andrology laboratory incubators, about embryologists, gynecologists, andrologists, nurse, and clinic lady is very important in IVF laboratory. After those all process, now we can define reprotoxicity. I want to talk about this point. Reprotoxicity is the effect of contact material on the gamete and embryology its functions. We understand reprotoxicity with low implantation rate and decreasing pregnancy rate. And if we explain quality control test methods for reprotoxicity, these are mouse embryo test, sperm survivor test, and hamster motility test, somatic cell culture, and other. We checked and confirmed these tests. This is most known quality test, mouse embryo test. It's safety and efficiency, the culture made and disposable are determined and observing in vitro development, mouse embryo exposed in item to be tested. Blastocyst formation and cell number should be above acceptance criteria. It might be upper 80%. And the second famous one test is sperm survival test. Sperm survival test, motility of spermatozoa test sample compared with control sample after 24, 96 hours, percentage of motility sperm control. It must be under 0.85. It will be toxic. It's one research about sperm survival test, test made by Nies and all friends, 36 products types, 72 different brands were tested in 350 human survival tests, and the research is very interesting. About 35% is where we how can reprotoxicity be reduced? We do about it? There is some methods we have, develop our laboratory test and sperm survival test except and disposable materials washable and use of mouse embryo test material always when available and culture and handling media and disposable. If we change, we can reduce reprotoxicity. Now, it's very important about for embryologists is quality control of laboratory equipment. We have a lot of equipment in IVF laboratory, like incubator, CO2 tubes, flow control, and control of clinic microscope, manipulator, pH meter, osmometer, heated working surveys, liquid nitrogen tanks, and etc. And checked hint indicator, morning temperature, thermometer, daily and evening CO2 indicators. We checked in the incubator morning and evening. It's also measured with the pump 3 times a week. Incubator waters change once a week. And everyday humidity control and microbiological control every 6 months, and pH measured weekly and when in laboratory new incoming media. And after by biomedical department or maybe company, it's maintenance and calibration 3 times a year, and gas and heat parameters should be observed at 48 hours, and filter strength is changed every 3 months. Now, in different studies, friends, that different CO2 levels change implantation rate, and implantation rates. Day 18 and fetal development phase per embryo for 5% may we see 68 for 6% we see 82% is very different and change for pregnancy.
Dr. Jenkins, please, we are running out of the time. If you can summarize the remaining of your 1 minute.
Okay. It's very okay. Laminar flow, we clean in 6 months. You know, our microscope is very important. We clean every day, and the daily cleaning we twice a year. Liquid nitrogen. We all check twice a week. Refrigerator and freezer, we know 2+ and 6+, and freezer means 18 and means 26. We know control media, you see certificate, and we check every time. CE, ISO, and tissue culture tested, and pH control is every time we need. And take home message I want to talk. IVF application is secure quality control system to be patient based. Standardization practices should be initiated. IVF treatment, single embryo transfer to be applied, establishing standards of cases should be standardized. All personnel should be aimed to complete laboratory practice and treatment infertility. We need for training, monitoring of the individual staff members. Selection of culture condition, individual laboratory culture strategy are complex and highly varied, and data which the base the selection of specific culture strategy. And the end, we must know how to monitor, calibrate, and osmometer. Handling of storage of consumables and including we need control of inventory. We need to discuss the importance and quality control and management. Our aim should be to increase the number of take-home babies. And I want to thank you all participants, organizing commission, IRIFIF, and my IVF team. And thank you so much, my dear friend.
Teşekkür ederim Dr. Ferhat for this excellent presentation.